Hello everyone. In this video, I am going to talk about amplification of gene of interest using PCR. What is amplification of gene? Amplification of gene means making multiple copies of gene. How? By using PCR, which stands for polymerase chain reaction. And it is a technique which causes replication of DNA in vitro. It is in vitro replication of DNA, and here the enzyme used is polymerase. Polymerase is an enzyme which polymerizes deoxyribonucleotide, and so it is very important for the synthesis of DNA strand. The idea of PCR was originated in early 70s, but it was made reality by Carrie Mullis in 1985. For his contribution, he was awarded with Nobel Prize along with Michael Smith in 1993 for chemistry. Polymerase chain reaction, that is, it's a basic technique used in the molecular or genetic experiments. The basic principle behind the PCR is that when the DNA molecule is heated at high temperature, it gets denatured. Due to this, the DNA molecule is converted into single-stranded DNA molecule. And later, with the help of polymerase enzyme, the duplication of the original DNA takes place, and this cycle is repeated several times, and the multiple copies of DNA is generated. This is that how PCR work. So now we will see that for this technique, what are the basic requirements. The first basic requirement is the DNA template. We need a fragment of DNA whose multiple copies are needed. Second basic requirement is primer, and the primer gets attached to each of the single strand, each of the strand of the DNA duplex, and their end. So one will get attached to this 3' of the DNA strand, and again here it will get attached to the 3' end of the DNA strand, and their end will face to each other. So this is second requirement, that is the primer. The third basic requirement for the PCR technique is polymerase enzyme. Polymerase enzyme, it helps in the synthesis of new DNA strand, and the most common used polymerase enzyme is TAC polymerase, and it is obtained from Thermus aquaticus. Why this enzyme, that TAC polymerase, is preferred than other polymerase enzyme? Because this polymerase can withstand with high temperature, since it is obtained from Thermus aquaticus, which is a thermophilic bacteria. When the DNA duplex is heated at high temperature, there is possibility that the polymerase enzyme will get denatured. So just to prevent that, TAC polymerase is used. The next requirement is ATP and magnesium ion. Now we'll see the working of PCR, and for that the DNA duplex is heated at high temperature, usually between 94 to 96 degrees centigrade. At that temperature, the hydrogen bond which is present between the strands of the DNA, they are broken, and it is converted into single stranded template. The next process is that is annealing. Annealing means joining. After heating the DNA duplex at high temperature, it is cooled to 50 to 60 degrees centigrade for less than a minute. At that time, the primer gets attached to the DNA single stranded template. So it occurs at the 3' end of the single stranded template, and the face, it is the 3' ends of the primer, they face each other. After annealing, The next step is the extension, that is primary extension or polymerization. And in this step, that with the help of polymerase enzyme, that new nucleotides are added at the 3OH end of the primer. And this is how, and the new nucleotides are simultaneously, they are joined, and the new strand of DNA is synthesized with the help of ATP, and the magnesium ion. This step is carried out at the temperature of 72 degrees. By this process, that the DNA strand will be synthesized. So you can see here, from one strand, that it was a single DNA duplex. Now from this single DNA duplex, this two DNA duplex has been synthesized, and this cycle is repeated several times, and we get the multiple copies of DNA. So here is a formula. If the cycle is repeated for n times, the number of copies generated by PCR will be 2 to power n. So in n cycle, the number of DNA copies generated equals to 2 to power n. PCR has various applications. First, in the detection of the pathogen, like in the detection of COVID-19, PCR is used to identify the presence of virus in the person. Second, it is used in the parental diagnosis. If a child is having any genetic disease, it can be detected before the birth. So here, that is, the PCR can be used in various type of diagnostic procedures.